Hello and welcome to yet another normal lesson for today. We had a good day today. As you can see, we are now 87 LP in gold 5. We climbed from, I think, literally 1 LP at the start of the day, and we did start off on a loss, so it wasn't a flawless day by any means. And even if in our one games we did make some errors, but you can see we sort of fell into a nice groove once we got rolling in the day here. We're doing just main and fill all day, but we got a bunch of games in. So that Morgana game was the first loss of the day. You know, unfortunate. It was one of those games where it's like, yeah, you know, it feels like it's hard to have an impact on Morgana. At the end of the game, I definitely started questioning buying these items instead of armor and buying sorcerer shoes instead of ninja tab eye because we were up against full AD. So it started to make itself painfully clear in my mind what I could have done better that game. So we're not going to review that one. And then we had some good games after that. I want to review possibly the Zyra game. Just because it didn't go too long. I wonder if it shows. Yeah, this actually wound up ending around 18, 19 minutes into the game. So you can kind of tell right why the Yasuo popped off there. It was pretty fun to get carried by Yasuo, who could just go crazy. But what I want to see in a game like this is what I could have done to involve myself in the snowball that's happening. Get myself involved in Yasuo's life, right? Be like, Yasuo, my long lost friend, it is time for some chilling. And, you know, start roaming over to that lane, helping him go even harder on Zed than he already was. Because if I could have done that, not only could I have freed him up to go elsewhere on the map even more than he already was doing, which you'll notice, it wasn't all kills on Zed. You know, he did smash that lane pretty hard, but he was moving around the map and transitioning that lead elsewhere. So I want to see how I could have involved myself there, because if I got a little bit ahead just from assisting him, getting some assist gold, that also could help snowball our bot lane. Which, you know, we ended up looking like we did a lot better than their bot lane did. It was a fiddle stick support. But we had a rough start. I do remember that the start wasn't the best that game. So, you know, I want to review, see how we could have done. Again, it's a Vayne ADC that I was supporting as Janna. Very passive lane, very not about fighting early. But nonetheless, we should be an okay lane for safety. Vayne is fairly short range, so it's a little dangerous. But it's not like we're up against Caitlyn, right? That range advantage doesn't mean as much because it's Lucian. Though he is a little mobile with that dash. I still want to see what I could have done better, and I'm not sure exactly, just trying to remember off the top of my head, what it was I could have done better, but I'm sure there's something, so I want to jump into it. At a certain point in the game, I'm sure we're just going to, and excuse me, this wasn't my Janna game, I just played Janna. It's a Zyra game, so there's a conflict there, right, where we don't want to fight because we have a Vayne. But we do want to fight because I'm Zyra, right? Like, I want to fight. And I think we got bullied. It's starting to come back to me. We got bullied pretty significantly early. Even though we did the isolation to make sure the crows from Fiddlesticks were only hitting one of us and then they just didn't bounce a lot, we were still getting beat out in the trades pretty heavily. So I want to go ahead and start reviewing this game. Let's hop right in. See what we could have done better. I don't know what the topic of today's lesson is going to be, but I think it's going to be one that's going to help me quite significantly. For any of you who checked out last episode's lesson, I just want you to know we're not putting these lessons out in isolation. These are actually things that I'm trying to apply to myself, help myself grow. And Twitch chat, of course, watching live helps me realize what some of those errors are, and from that we grow, you know, we improve our game, and one of the ways that we improve is we start practicing those things. So Positional awareness and map awareness were the, I believe, the last two episodes. The last episode for sure was map awareness. And so what we decided to do is change up the drills we're doing every day at the start of the stream. Instead of just doing plain last hitting drills, we're actually drilling against a bot to try and learn how to dodge skill shots, be aware of my own position when I'm trying to focus on last hitting. And we actually incorporated a timer that every 10 seconds would give us a beep noise. And that's when I would have to look down at the mini map until I can say, okay, you know, top lane's pushing, mid lane's frozen but is about to push inward towards us. And then I can go back to focusing on the area proper. You know, this is to... I'm going to actually pause right here because stuff's already happening, right? That part of the drilling is to try and make both my map awareness better and improve the frequency with how quickly I can glance at the map and just tell what's happening from a glance. So let's get right into this. We did start this out with a little bit of invade. Just got some vision, nothing too major. Now, if I was here for this, this could have gone a little bit differently. We might have been able to get something out of it. But I want to go here because you guys all know I start with that pink ward right there, that control ward. I want to slam this down in this bush and get rolling back down to lane so I can get as many of my passive plants seeding in lane as possible. So that means I won't be able to leash either. So it kind of makes me a little bit null and void at the start of the game. And yes, for anyone who's curious, Fiddlesticks, I don't know how to show you, but he did go Deathfire Touch. I believe I have been seeing a number of Fiddlesticks do that, so I think that's just the meta thing to do as the support fiddle, because you're all about poking with the crows and refreshing that. Amumu's doing the start on the Razorbeaks, on the Raptors. I got the pink ward there, and I got down to lane. Unfortunately, we did miss a double spawn. This was when I was walking back from the pink ward, but now that I'm here, my passive has been up for a little while. We didn't lose any on that last chunk, but it's doing the thing where my passive will be up, but it doesn't want to trigger because I'm too close to a wall. There we go. Had to get my glove back on. So I'm just trying to throw a little poke. It's unfortunate that the vision from that gave it to me. And this is, I think that's the worst time that we had with Fiddlesticks crows. That's a perfect example of how Fiddle wants to get his crow off, right? Because it hit both of us twice, or hit Vayne twice and me once, and bounced through the whole minion wave twice. So it's going to push it in, it's going to suck some of that control away from us, and it's going to silence us so I can't answer with a trade back, and it's good chunk damage, because those crows do actually a surprisingly large amount of damage. So that's not how you want to play it. And I think after that, evermore, we played it correctly. So this is some good harass. I'm trying to, since I took, again, I don't know where to show it to you guys, but you're going to have to believe me, I took Thunderlords. I'm going to try and spawn these plants in a way to just get one or two autos from a plant onto him with whatever ability I use to cast it, probably Q if I'm going for something far range like that. If it's something that I can know we can engage on, I'll use my E, which is my root. But the E plants have a shorter range than the Q plants, so if I'm just poking, trying to get my Thunderlords off and get the refresh on it, the cooldown for that going, then I'm going to use my Q. That was good. Procced it on Fiddlesticks. Fiddle, of course, can just heal up on the minion wave, so not the most effective to try and harass him, but nonetheless, it's good. Going forward, that's a good example of how to take the crow. Move away from the minions and away from your ally immediately and just eat it so it doesn't get any of the bounce value. That makes it so it's not really that strong of an ability. It becomes strong when it gets a lot of the value out of bouncing to multiple targets. So I thought they were going to actually walk a little bit more forward here. That was probably just an error on my part, because Lucian, I thought, we're playing so far back that he might want to go up a little bit closer, try and start zoning us away. But, you know, he's not playing super aggressive. It feels like we've lost some of these trades just because that fiddle poke is pretty good. And he's going to be healing up, and I'm not really going to be healing up. And because I do start with that pink ward, I'm always at a disadvantage in lane as far as the biscuits go. Control ward. But you know, from that plant I do, it did focus Lucian, so it got a little damage on him. Proc the Thunderlords, not bad. Unfortunately, this was just, when this happened in game, this just hurts. When you throw down the Q, but they're already like right here, so they can just crush the plant and already be gone. Like, it hurts, and that's just something that I haven't played Zyra in a while, so I wasn't as aware of where my plants were spawning and trying to maximize the value there. It does get one bounce off that minion, but Vayne still very largely playing these correct. She moved away as quickly as possible. Wonderful. So, plant management, right? Again, I think this is something just from my lack of playing Zyra for a while. I've gotten a little rusty on. But let's actually go back to look at where those were, right? So I'm level 2. So I'm not spawning these intentionally. These are all coming from my passive. I think it comes out right about now. Perfect. Okay. So these are the plants that I have spawned recently. So this one's not about to expire. The previous one that was about to expire just did. So we've got a little bit of time. So basically, each plant I will say will give a ring about that of control. So we've got about that much ring of just control for our area. Right? Okay. I got a little wild with the scribbles there. I'm not the best artist. Sorry, guys. So anytime there's somebody who walks into that zone is when I should try and trigger that. And we see Fiddle starting to walk towards there. He came from over here and is now walking behind minions in that general direction. So it looks like, okay, it might be a good time for me to spawn these two plants here and create that larger zone of danger. It might actually even be further range than that, because I'll be using my Q to do it. But I want to start moving around this way towards those plants. I am staying a little bit back because Lucian can always do the short range dash and then have the double shot ready. So I want to be careful. And Fiddlestick's now level 2. We haven't seen him use Drain yet, I don't think. So he might have gone, as far as I know, with the Fear as a second ability. As we see cheating with all the eyes of everyone, we can tell that he did. I believe that's something that I should be checking in game when I'm up against Fiddlesticks. I should be making sure I know how his abilities are coming out in these first couple levels. And since I know that he has Terrify, I just got to stay a certain distance away from him. And I unfortunately didn't know that 100% in game, but I was assuming that was his max path. So right there, he turns back. And I think I've just now started the animation. So he was about here. He would be about here when the plant would spawn. So I think that's just a really, really well done juke by Fiddle. To seeing that I'm coming here, just immediately start walking back, you know? There's no reason to commit to trying to crush one of these plants, these seeds. Just walk back, don't risk taking any free damage. And maybe I'll accidentally burn some mana and burn these plants, because once they're summoned, those seeds are gone. They don't get, like, they don't speed up a refresh rate for me of getting new seeds back out there or anything like that. I just use them and they're expended, you know? So unfortunately, that is what happens. Lucian's out of range. That was just an auto for me. So it's level 3 to level 2 right now. So having a little bit of zone control up while that happens is not bad, but not the most critical thing. I'm watching this plant that just spawned, seeing if I can try and root Fiddle when he goes into this bush, because I didn't know that this ward was up, I might have known this ward was up and that he was coming for it, but I was just keeping an eye out. Now that I'm seeing this plant is about to be seeded right here, I might throw out a Q, but now he's completely in range. If I root him right now, rooted, and that plant is definitely within range. So that's what I go for. Unfortunately, I'm just a little slow on the trigger, I think. And this is going to be just a horrible trade. So let's go back and let's watch the setup for this, right? Because this is what I felt was telling you guys at the start in the intro. I feel like I didn't do very well this lane. I think it's this one trade here that really put us back. Because, you know, this is, you know, largely an even lane. Maybe they have a slight advantage. One, because they're leveled. These health discrepancies will be less once we level as well. That's another thing, too. Just right off the start. Like, there's no reason to try and force and engage as aggressively as I'm doing when we're under-leveled like that. I should be a little bit more aware of what our power windows are, and this is not a power window for us. So I'm going forward. Vayne is completely out of this engagement, especially since she's a low-ranged ADC. So I see right now the casting animation for his hook, because he's Captain Fiddlesticks or whatever, for his crow being thrown out. So I want to get the ability, if I'm going to go for this, I want to get the abilities off right now. I'm only able to get one, and again, he's able to crush that plant just before it starts. I think that's just good play by Fiddle. I don't think there was a lot of misplays from me in trying to cast to trigger this plant. Maybe it would have been better to use Q. And I couldn't use it like that because it Q from where you started. It's like, I'm trying to think of another ability that has that sort of circle. It uses you as the point of access, and it turns as you turn. So if I wanted to cast it here, it would be a box like this. And if I wanted to cast it here, it would be a box like that because it rotates around the circumference. So I could... It would be really hard to try and get it. I would try and cast it something like this. Maybe that would work. Maybe something like that could work. Because the hitbox on the damage is only, you know, so much. But there's an additional wider hitbox for summoning plants that are around it. So I think it could be possible to trigger both of these plants, though it'd be tough. And we have no minions. So the minions are going to roast my two little plants pretty quickly. And as we can see just from the start of this, the damage, I'm very vulnerable, right? Vayne's playing properly where she should, behind this turret. Or at least, again, behind the line of safety that a turret provides. And I'm just too far forward. I think that's by far the main mistake with disengage. Again, we're level 2 still, even after, you know, they cleared our whole next minion wave. There's no reason I should be taking this fight other than I was greeding to try and make the most out of these plants. And I think proper plant management involves letting some plants be stepped on, because it also gives them a little bit of air of confidence in trying to kill your plants. So it's not the worst thing in the world if they do get one or two plants down. So I think I need to be a little bit more giving with letting them crush my plants early if it's not the ideal time to engage. Or, if I'm not 100% sure that using that ability to summon those plants is going to use those plants effectively, like happened here earlier where I summoned those two plants and they didn't really do much the whole time. So, I have to flash immediately. And I learning from one of our previous lessons, I use that flash. I don't hesitate. Pop it instantly. Good. Good play. Making the best out of a horrible situation. But that was the correct play. So, me and the biscuit. Gonna try and hang around, because it is early levels, and we just now level to level 3. So I'm thinking, okay, you know, I can still just stay way far back, summon my plants, because again, now that I have them, I can direct them as well. Do a good job there, eating the crow. And we're going to be okay. This is enough health to play with. Vayne does still have heal. I don't want to lean on that by any means. But I also don't want to abandon her to 2v1 lane this quickly. It's one thing to give Vayne solo experience. It's another thing to just abandon her. So I don't want to do that. I want to hang out if possible. Make the most out of the threats. This is just really nice. And it begins, as you guys can tell. it begins. I think he actually does go down here. But Amumu follows up with a kill. So that's good. It's nice to have that. That always helps. Keeping myself, even though I'm low, in presence means these are big threats, right? And they do offer some zone control. Maybe not as much now that I'm low, because we can they can just engage past them and come for me, and then retreat away from them. When they're not like, you know, Daisy. When I die, Daisy dies. That's not how it works. The plants have their own individual timers, so they do provide that zone control regardless of my life status. though certainly I don't want to die. Because I won't be able to spawn additional plants, and I'll be dead. Who wants to die? Why would you want to do that? So Phil takes a free church shot there, and that's helpful. I'm hanging around here because that gives me very good control for a couple things. Obviously, I can just queue in a couple directions, right? I can have that kind of hitbox, or I can have this kind of hitbox, which, since I can use it in a couple different ways, the actual zone of that box sort of gets extended to here, and all of this sort of becomes dangerous for them. So they don't really want to walk in any of that area, which gives us a little bit of control over here, so Vayne can come a little bit closer to get these last hits without having to worry too much. So that's good. And of course it does keep the plants alive, so they can continue to provide that, because the timer on the plants themselves is really long. On the seeds, rather. The plants is fairly short, but the seeds are quite long. So as long as I can keep them off them, I don't have to trigger them immediately like I was doing earlier. I can just manage them in a bit more of a passive way and try and build up a farm of them, and then use them during a large engagement. So, got two more spawned here. That's really good. This gives us a big defensive line by our turret and gives us a huge zone of safety right here. So that's good. Unfortunately, the minions don't push too far forward before the line is established, because that means that they can play a little bit forward after shoving this wave and try and start threatening these. But at the same time, it's not bad, because now if they try and fight and engage to punish Vayne coming for these initial last hits on these melee minions, or if the cannon comes up, we've got a zone of protection right here. So not bad. Again, you'll see my plants are stacking pretty quickly. These last ones have all been from my passive. So that's very good. That's just going to be a plant loss. That's fine. I back away to not bounce the crow to me, but I'm waiting. And right here is the perfect opportunity. So let's jump back. Because as you can kind of see there, I think I lose some of those plants. And I think there was a way to get those plants to trigger. So it's right here, right? This crow is coming towards Vayne. So I can't be within a certain range of Vayne. Otherwise, that crow is going to bounce to me. And then I'm going to be silenced and can't do anything anyway. Because if you get hit by the crow, you also get silenced for a short duration. So I need to not be near Vayne. I notice this. I kind of start to walk back this way initially, because I want to give Vayne room to not juke away from me, and in doing so, isolate herself by juking this way into a 2v1, right? I want to give her a little space, so I start running this way immediately and then start to juke a little bit down to create the distance now that the crow is about to arrive and bounce. And the crows do prioritize champions that they haven't bounced to yet. So I want to try and extend that range. I get it just large enough to where the crow generously decides to bounce back to the wave. Now that it has, it's bouncing between these pretty quickly, but the duration of it isn't too long. So right now, I'm plenty far back. I actually can probably be outside of this boundary and the crows won't bounce. Maybe a little bit more like that, and the crows won't bounce to me. So this is a little bit too defensive. I think I need to be a little bit more around here. Now that this has happened, I need to be a little bit closer to Vayne again, immediately start moving towards her, because I could then cast my box right here. All four of these plants would summon. That would give us immense zone of control right here and a minor zone of control here. And that means if Lucian tries to engage onto this Vayne, who has a low health bar, as you can see, he's going to be in a lot of danger because those plants are doing a lot of damage to him. Even though he's starting out great, that trade will not be won. So I need to have already moved a little bit more forward, recognizing that the crow threat is largely over. And I might already need to just trigger this. It is arguable that right now I should do that defensively because his double shot is ready right now. Because he just used piercing light, I believe. So it's arguable that I should be summoning them right now. Definitely upon seeing this, I need to cast that immediately. And it's because of this range of being back that extra step. If I was already right here instead, I would be in perfect range and position to cast and catch all of these, right? All of these would be summoned. Instead, oops, there we go. Instead, it takes an extra second for me to start coming into the spot where I can reach them. And in doing so, two of my plants are immediately crushed. Now that I throw it down, now that I see that, I think, okay, let me just try and create a zone here that will isolate them and make them split up. And that'll protect Vayne. Because now that I was slow to pull the trigger, this becomes about protecting Vayne. So even though those two plants are crushed, I'm throwing down one using my W, that's what this one was, and triggering the remaining one from my passive by using a bar like this. It's not trying to hit Fiddle, it's not trying to give us zone control to prevent Fiddle from entering into the fight. It's trying to zone like this and make Lucian go away and leave Vayne a nice retreat path down or even just straight down like that. And now that he's used his dash, he can't dash straight down. So if she's to juke straight down, he would have to walk through the plants. This probably slightly tilted being the most optimal retreat path. So I get that off. They get off their initial shot, so he does get Thunderlord, so he gets chunked a little bit. And the range on them is alright. Plants do a little bit of work here. They hold off the minions. But again, I think this is making the best out of a poor situation. I think overall, it's arguable that they won that trade, even though I think I probably got it off as much or more damage than Lucian did, just because it puts our Vayne so low. She's almost blinking red, right? And that's going to make it immensely hard for her to farm, especially as a low mobility, short range champion. So there's my passive coming into action. This was an unfortunate time because, that was a perfect time for Fiddle to use his crow. Because we're so grouped together, I can't juke forward into a piercing light, so I've got to run back. And I'm running straight through more minions bringing the crow to Vayne. And that's great poke damage. I do manage to get far enough away from the minions to not allow it to bounce back further after it hits me a second time. But now, if you calculate that in with the trade, look at that. We're almost both blinking red, right? This is horrible. We're really far suppressed right now. And again, I think this comes back to the plant management earlier. So I step forward, both to give Vayne a little cover, but also just to try and trigger these plants to zone them away. Because, one, I know Lucian's going to be focusing a bit on these last hits. But two, if they can pressure and claim the zone of control, these plants are gone, and they're going to be able to keep us way back here. Any future plants that will be spawned could be as far away as this area, because I'm going to have to be playing back here behind the turret, and they're going to be getting free damage in on the turret. Not as significant, because they're only level 4, it's not that big of a deal, but it certainly does, you know, help to get this. So if I can do this largely for free, that's fine. So I get those off, He actually manages to crush that plant right as it's spawning. And I don't think the piercing light hits me there. I think it's just some damage from Fiddlesticks. But I get a little bit of damage off. The plants being, like, really strong, they're showcasing why they're so strong. Even in that, I do get the Thunder Lords off. And that's the kind of long range the Q plants have. The root plants have a little bit shorter range, but these plants from the Q are quite long. So we actually managed to get Lucian to that blinking red range in exchange for myself, which, okay, I will take that trade. I think that's a fine trade because I can stay back and play safe. Since he rotates over there, it opens up an opportunity for me to throw down a ward and tribe rush to make sure we're not dove. Okay. Now, you did notice I juked back a little bit before completely leaving. This was actually intentional. I was trying to, I think, both threaten that I was coming for this plant and just try and zone Fiddle back. But look at how, I mean, Fiddle is basically 100% HP. And he took Ignite, right? I think I actually said during the live stream about how people, once they're in lane, will forget about how Ignite is the combat summoner choice for the support, and then they won't play respecting that. And I make that mistake here. Absolutely. So he flash ignites me, and that alone is probably enough to finish me off since I don't have any more biscuits left. Crow and Otto for good measure. Might have been able to Crow Vayne, get a little bit of shove and a little bit of harass there. Doesn't matter, he secures it. A Moomoo gets here, right? So as this is happening, so at this point a Moomoo is coming. I'm able to throw that down. Here's a Moomoo. That gives me a little bit of confidence to make this play, because again, it's right here that I go, like, I'm trying to trigger this plant or zone Fiddle away. Amumu's backing me up. Vayne's here. This is a decent line. It obviously would be better if Amumu was in this bush, right? But this is decent. I still think it's far too aggressive because I'm the one who's the lowest. If Vayne was far lower and I, like, our hit points were swapped, I could see this play working. But this is just too aggressive, I think. And I don't even try and trigger it. I just try and immediately run. It's too late. Amumu, seeing that this has happened, comes in, tries to immediately make the play. I did get my root off. He was planning for Fiddle to keep walking. I don't think he saw my root was coming out, so that's a little unfortunate. And now Vayne, already being so low, comes into effect. She does throw out the heal to keep herself happy, and she does manage to condemn Fiddle against the wall. And that's what makes this trade end up working out a little bit better in our favor. Very close. Very close. Razor's Edge. And the reason this wasn't a complete disaster, I think largely just luck, right? Lucian trying to dash in near a wall. Didn't have to be that way. You're listening to him cry right now. This is easily one auto attack from Lucian, let alone from his passive where he gets off a double shot. That's a dead Vayne. So this could have been a 2v or a 2-for-1 in a 3v2. Because I wasn't managing my plants properly at the start. And then because I, again, by trying to step forward like that, it's as if I was threatening usage of this plant. Improper way to use that plant. That plant could have just been, hey, come step on me so Moomoo can land the Q. Then I can be some follow-up engage and root him and make sure we get that for free, and this isn't nearly as close. That would be proper plant management. This was improper. Just trying to care for them and pop them, give them life, you know, and let them do their damage, their planty damage. That's not how you manage plants properly. And I know that. And it's just a mistake. Just rust showing. And it is something I need to be more aware of with Zyra. So I'm waiting for a little extra gold. No, I was actually deciding if I should go four biscuits. And after, we did go even, but after that, I'm like, yeah, I'm going to make sure that I have plenty of regeneration for this lane, and we're going to out-trade them. And I'm going to try and play a little bit better. So we'll see what that actually amounts to, right? We'll see. Amumu's jetting out because he doesn't want to take this fight, knowing that Fiddlesticks could be coming, which in fact he is. It's a little bit caught out there. Might be all right. Seeing this, I start moving up. I think let's actually go back just a little bit, because in watching, I don't know why you heard like my death animation there. Right now, there we go. Right now is when, like I'm pretty sure we saw Fiddle come up here. So already before, I should be pathing up through here. It's arguable that I should have seen in time to have pathed at least up like that to get an optimal path. But I should hug this wall and be walking like this, right? Immediately. So I want to see, given that that's something that I should for sure be doing at this point, I want to see if I micro'd that properly. And I did. I'm hugging the wall properly, and I'm walking up this path. But now that he's been successfully cut off by Fiddle, I need to walk behind the Silk Road here and try and meet up here and provide support. Hopefully with Yasuo coming down as well. He just got the kill onto Zed, so I'm not sure how healthy he's going to be in a few moments. But if he can do the dash way through the minions and then meet us down here, he can give us additional support. That's what I should be thinking, right? Though I shouldn't rely on Yasuo, given that he just killed the Zed. And it is probably going to be pretty low. Even though he's not low now necessarily, he's there with no minions, so he's going to get low. So this is a few seconds. It doesn't matter too much yet. The pathing could be slightly more optimal, but that's a very negligible amount. It's just, okay, right there. Okay, there's a moment in which I decide not to. I went from there to here instead. Let's actually see how long it takes to correct that. So I actually go all the way over to here first before coming back. So if this long route instead were here, trying to get this estimate about right, be about here, roughly speaking, give or take, right? So the ultimate change is about that much distance, right? What's that, four Teemos? Three, four Teemos? So let's see if that ends up mattering. This is where they get the stun off. Yasuo, as it does turn out, is too low to be able to help in this situation. So he's just cheating up to the top side as much as he can and trying to take these out, get that extra farm. Seems about right. Mumu's full health, so he should be okay. Now, he keeps running up this way towards Yasuo here. Why does he do that, right? It's because the closest support, even though it's a dead Yasuo and an alive Zyra, I'm not quite here to support him yet. This is the clearest path to somebody who could support you. Now, let's go back and look. What if I were, what's that, 1, 2, 3, 4? If I was about here, maybe he would have pathed differently. I would be right here at the very bottom of the screen. Maybe from here, he paths differently, knowing that I can throw the root. And in doing so, maybe we can keep him alive here. So that's entirely possible that was my fault that he died there, because I didn't rotate quickly enough. Yeah, I'm just thinking, it obviously depends on what he would have done, but he's a rational actor, right? he moved towards who he pathed towards whoever was the best person. He tried to path optimally away from the threat towards support. And this is more support than this if I'm much further away. So I think if I'm closer, we might be able to save him. Maybe not get a return kill or anything. But we definitely, not definitely, but possibly could have saved a Mumu there. There's a whole bunch of rippling consequences, of course, to not having your jungle on the map. And look at this. This is why I mentioned, like, we might have been able to get a return kill. Maybe. Maybe we could have. That fiddle was pretty low. So, who knows? Unfortunate. Since Yasuo had to back, I hang out here. Consider shoving the wave side against it. Want to leave it froze for Yasuo. Want to get back to lane. Because now I've been far enough away to where, one, I don't want to be leaving this many plants away from where I'll need them. And two, Vayne and me will be arriving roughly at the same time back in lane. So I decided to go back to lane and just reunite with Vayne. So yeah, a little bit better of rotations could have made a big impact there. But we'll leave that be for now. You guys see the kind of generous range I'm talking about with the hitboxes. Unfortunately, I don't think that triggered my Thunderlords on him. Because the E plant, again, you'll notice the range on this plant is actually fairly short. I think Lucian outranges it. So he was able to be okay there. Fortunately, couldn't get it off in time. Just another bad example of plant management. Let's actually review that. Because this is one spawn from my passive, so I'm way back. But I'm walking right towards it. Right here, I should just already. Like, look at that. I'm auto-attacking the ward. Right now, that Q could be slammed down. I could be spawning another plant right next to it. And this could be two plants attacking him. That very much could have been a bunch of free damage, like at least that much damage on dilution for free, but I'm not having proper plant management again. You know, cut me some slack. It's been a while since I played Zyra, but that is pretty poor plant management, and that's all she is a champion, is managing her plants effectively. So I'm trying to throw out the roots to try and snare him, and I'm doing it from Fog of War. I'm summoning the plant in front of me. Poor plant management. There's no reason to do this. This isn't going to be in range of anything. The important thing was to trigger this plant quickly, right? So let's go back. Did I trigger that plant quickly? Once I saw Fiddle was going to be moving in that direction. I start positioning, because wherever Lucian can go with his dash, I can get a good summon on him by trying to root. I've got about, from my position, I've got a range through this plant to have my root hit anywhere from here to here. So all of this is dangerous for Lucian. Although he can dash outside of that a little bit in this area would be the aggressive option. He would be dashing directly into minions. This is probably a safe area for Vayne. So I'm positioning here not just to get this plant protected, which I can do what I end up doing where I throw it from the Fog of War of the bush to try and trigger if he was walking over to it, to both root him just outside and summon the plant. So that's what I'm doing. I think this is proper zoning with the plants. But seeing Fiddle come right here. Once he's, even before he's here, when he was back here, or like right there, Lucian's already so far away now, I can take a more forward position. There's no reason I need to be positioning myself behind this plant. This is a plant I can summon in the secondary backline if the engagement stays protracted and they're advancing on us, right? This is the only plant that's relevant to these guys right now. This doesn't matter, so there's no reason to summon this. And if I instead was right here, I could be casting something, if not in this moment in the game, right here, like I was. And that, for sure, would have triggered this plant before he could crush it and root it in. So, really poor plant management there. Just to get the Thunderlords off, I have to use one of my stored plants and a whole ability that costs mana. I do, so we end up winning the trade there. And again, look at that absurd range of the Q plants compared to the E plants for the root ability, right? Monstrous. But that could have been done much better. Vayne does a good job of not bouncing that. Crow. So I don't think we have any vision of where they're at right now. Or excuse me, not red, blue. Yeah, we don't know where they're at. Ping to be careful because we don't know. I'm playing as if they're in this bush, right? Juke forward, juke right back. Okay, as soon as we know that that's the case, okay, I can step a little bit more forward. Because Lucian not being there means Fiddle was probably the one that went there. I would be very surprised if... I mean, it's entirely possible for Udyr to solo it, but usually people group together just for a little extra security. So I can manage this plant a little bit more effectively than I'm doing right now. Instead of positioning right here with Vayne, I can position like right here with Vayne, and that'll give me better control over this plant. So there's a little mismanagement going on over my plants right now. Like right where Vayne is where I should be playing. Like we could be completely swapped, or we could both be over where Vayne is. Now that I have a plant here, there is a reason to be here. And this is the more forward plant right now that's relevant to both of them. So hanging around this is pretty good. And I'm actually trying to position ever closer to this plant. Because if I position closer, this now becomes one that I can get for free to sort of have as a buffer if they come in on me. And I can summon my stored plants wherever they are. And I can open up with my root ability. And once the animation is started for my root, I can throw down my stored plants afterwards. If you have quick enough reaction time. But once you play a few games of Zyra, you get that. So I would be able, if I was going to root somebody, to summon plants right around them. And then I would have a plant here to be serve as like a personal bodyguard. So that's what I'm thinking right now. I think this is okay. This is aggressive positioning, but that's what Zyra's known for. This I don't think is the best route, and I'm trying to do here exactly what I was describing. Here's why. Vayne's already so far back, she's not going to be able to easily participate if this does root Lucian. This is fine. This gives me a little bit of zone control. But all that's happening is the plants that I throw down from my W are going to be hitting Lucian if this does in fact root him, right? It gets a little bit of damage onto the minions without taking them. So Vayne can get those or him. But that makes this a zoning attempt. This is not really that great. At best, it's a zoning usage. He does have to dash. I do summon the one plant. But Fiddle is the one who gets the only poke that trade. Not very good. Little mismanagement of the plants there. Take that for free, unfortunately. But I do contain it. So that's not bad. This plant needs to just be seeded. Now, as soon as the passive starts summoning a second plant, it becomes very juicy to not do that. And you would think that perhaps they would go straight for it. Right? So going all in on this zone to make the most out of these plants is an option. I'm not sure if I properly started the Q before the W. I want to watch this again. Let's pay attention to my animation and watch that cool down for the Q, rather. So it's gonna, my passive is about to spit it out. Let's watch. No. So I throw down the first one before I trigger the Q. It looked like from the cooldown, the Q was about the same time as the second one. But doing that gives them plenty of advance notice that, hey, Zyra is about to throw down the zone right here. All they need is seeing that plant from my stored seeds placed to know that this is happening. Or I'm going to throw out the root, right? So they know to back up and be out of the root range. So basically in this zone and in this zone. Or just back far enough here to where if it is the root that comes out, they can just retreat or juke as needed, right? So they're reacting properly. This is just a poor choice to go all in with that here. Now, luckily, Fiddlesticks does actually make an error and try and like step on them before they get summoned. And they do trigger just in time to where I get a huge chunk on Fiddle. It winds up doing a bunch of damage. And Lucian, in response, decides to try and go all in with the ultimate. Now, this is a trick that you can do against Zyra if you are a Fiddle player. If you throw out the Crow, it'll chunk these plants out pretty quick and it'll kill them. So with that, in addition to the minions attacking them, that's going to sweep these out. But that's the thing about these plants, right? I mean, you can see the white bar is how much time they have left in their life before they just time out. These plants are almost done, right? The majority of their time on this earth has already passed. So in staying here trying to fight them like that, you're just going to take an additional round of attacks from them, and it's probably not worth it. The amount of gold they give is only like 5. It's not really worth it to try and kill them if you can save your own health, especially if a fight is happening right now. And he's so low that he's going to have some problems. So I have to, meanwhile, right, the choline is coming out from Lucian, as we see here. So I have to run this way to prevent, because it was already, it started between us, and then he moved down this way. So it was boxing me in, so I had to move down to again stay out of range. And now I'm pinned against the wall. So what I can do is he's going to continue to go down slightly to get these last few shots in the proper position to hit me. So what I do here is I throw out my E. Because, okay, maybe you'll get a couple extra shots of the choline, but I'm going to root you. And if I had stored plants that I didn't already throw down here with a kind of questionable use of my plant management, if nothing else, you're going to be rooted right here. Might be just out of range of the turret. Might not be, if I'm lucky. Probably is, though. But that gives Vayne an opportunity to respond. Because if this choline is down, and notice Vayne is 6. Unfortunately, I'm not right now. But Vayne is 6. So there's an opportunity for Vayne to go all in on Lucian if he gets rooted in an optimal place, especially if he's taking turret aggro. So I think this is a really good root here. And we see he was in range just a little bit, but just a little bit out. Not quite. One plant throws a shot in on him. Nothing else comes of it. I still think that was the right play. Again, notice how low Fiddle is. Because Fiddle made that error walking into those 4 seeds, this turns out to be a favorable trade for us. It wouldn't have been otherwise if Fiddle had just backed away properly. And even if Lucian kind of isolated himself and went in with that choline, we would have had to micro around the choline similarly. Lucian right here. Maybe Vayne could have come up above it and started to try and trade with him. But Fiddle would have already been here coming around. So if an engagement broke out in this area, Fiddle's already coming here, and these plants can't reach. Because remember, those plants were used with the Q, so they have quite a range. But this, you could even come around more like this even. Still be safe. Fiddle, if he was, instead of walking through the plants to try and crush them, just started this path immediately, he probably could have been here by the time the choline was coming down and I was being pressed against the wall. Like we saw. But I got lucky, right? I got lucky. Little mismanagement of the plants, I think, but I do think I got lucky and it ended up working out. So that's nice. It's always nice to be lucky. I think there's an old saying, I'd rather be lucky than good. I'm not sure I agree with that. I'd rather be both. If that's an option. good management of veins. Passive to clear those minions without accidentally getting the third proc and then screwing up the last hit of it. That's fine. We don't see where Lucian is. I'm using these two plants to help me. Now, I see the passive, and this is again from the passive. The passive goes pretty wildly. So it'll do stuff like this on occasion. So this is fine. This bolsters the zone of control I already had from here. It expands it out this way. So good. All of this is now our zone right now. This is an interesting seed, right? Because we don't know where Fiddle is. We assume he backed because he took so much damage. We don't know this, though. So Fiddle could be in this bush, right? We have to play as if he were. Because why would Lucian be taking these so confidently without his ultimate when Vayne has hers? Notably, I still don't have mine yet because I'm just a little bit short of the experience needed. But we got to assume that if he's playing this aggressively, even though I'm not six yet, I'm about to be, and he knows that. So he's got to have backup here. If not Fiddle, maybe somebody else in the fog of war, right? Maybe Udyr is around here. So we got to play a little cautiously. But this is an opportunity to engage, because we're engaging into a plant back there, if I can trigger it before he can crush it. So I start moving forward, but then I think the gap is just too far. There's no way, if he's already right here, that I'm going to be able to do anything from here. So I start pathing back towards Vayne, regroup, try and orient myself to be parallel with this, so one Q would be able to hitbox all of these. But he starts to go down. So this presents me with an opportunity to perhaps change my orientation thought, right? I can have my Q come out like this to trigger some plants with a positioning here. And then I can be in line for an E through both of these plants. And then we could have zones like this without any plants being thrown down from my W stored seeds, right? If I threw down just even one seed right there, boom. Look at all this area of zone control. This is insane. This is insanity. This is the kind of zone control Zyra can provide for with proper plant management. So, whoops, let's clear that. So I think moving up right now is the proper angle to take. Instead, I'm juking back down this way. I think committing to these and then having access to that one. I think this gave me a lot of opportunity I'm not using, and I'm mismanaging the plants right now. We don't know if Fiddle's in here channeling an ultimate or preparing to channel an ultimate like Fiddles are wont to do. But nonetheless, I think this is enough distance being over here northeast of where Vayne is, to have a gap with Fiddle and be okay. I finally start to move forward and position myself. Now I'm in the right position, but look at what's changed, right? In the time it took, we lost minions, right? Because Lucian's got the AoE and Vayne doesn't, he's able to push this out. And his passive helps him kill the minions quicker, and Vayne's doesn't. We're not winning this shove. So now that I'm positioned here, I'm a little bit more vulnerable because we've only got four minions on our side, and this doesn't even really provide that much control because it's way focused and outnumbered. So a call for help doesn't really give us much because these might not answer a call for help. But if I'm in this position, anything I do to Lucian calls for help. All of those minions, all seven of them. That's a lot. That's a full minion wave. From scratch, that's more than a full minion wave if it's not a cannon wave, right? So this is actually a very vulnerable position. And I take it because I recognize for the plant management, this is such a good spot. It gives so many opportunities for zone shots, right? But I'm so late in getting there because I wasn't moving quickly because I didn't recognize my plant management is rusty and I didn't recognize that I needed to be there sooner. At this point, I might just say, okay, let's abandon this plant and juke back a little bit And then if he starts to go to crush it, maybe I can go forward and try and get the root and then engage like that and leave these plants alone. If I land that root, throw my Q down on top of it, try and throw down some seeds there, and then try and make the engagement point over here with us in this area, Vayne able to enter this way, which could give us enough room for a Fiddle ultimate to come out, and us still to be able to Vayne to condemn it away, so he would be back towards here, this area probably. Maybe not hit the wall, but it could just be knocked back and give us time to retreat. And in the meantime, getting a lot of free damage on Lucian. Fiddle comes out of the Fog of War, because now he's come back from base. Now it's too late. We've lost this control for free. Didn't make anything of it. I mean, there's nothing you can do about that. I didn't know where Fiddle was. So, you know, we had a feeling since he'd been gone for a while that he went back to base. We didn't know if he got back quicker because we didn't know what his items were yet. He could have gone Moby Boots instead of getting this Fiendish Codex. So it's possible he was in this bush the whole time. Had to play to respect that, but I could have made use of this sooner, and even maybe made a hard engage of that. Instead, nothing comes of it. A little bit of mismanagement of the plants. And now, again, look at this further mismanagement, right? He's already kind of meandered around in his fiddlestick sort of walk. He's already come around like this. And now he's here threatening these two plants. I'm still positioned over here on what is arguably, since there's two plants in Fog of War and one plant in Plain Vision, this is the weak side of the map for us. This is much stronger. Even as the minions sort of form a concave in this direction, this is definitely stronger because we have plants forming a concave with the minions more strongly. This one is kind of out of place to be supported, and these are not. These form a nice concave. So I think staying in this area instead of moving down to here, because I could be right here, and when Fiddle comes this way, I can throw down a Q right here, and I can E this way, so the range of the Q plants will trigger first, so he'll be in range to be attacked, and he'll notably be the only thing in range to be attacked if he gets rooted here, because this minion might be out of range, at least for this plant, but he wouldn't be. It's possible. Be interesting to have seen. I wish I would have done that. And in throwing out this E here, I could have just definitely spawned two plants here that would have for sure aggroed him. And remember, if you do hit them with abilities, it makes the plants focus them. So if I had moved down to here to manage these plants instead of this one, I would have had proper management. We would have had a great opportunity to open up onto Fiddlesticks, really chunk him out, because he is the squishier, or well, he's arguably equally squishy as Lucian. Unfortunately, I missed the root. I throw down two plants here, so I unload my seed reserves just to make sure, because I thought it was going to hit him. Unfortunately, it doesn't. That's just, you know, it happens sometimes. But because of that, these plants do still get at least one hit each to trigger Thunderlords on him. A little bit of damage, not much, but whatever. It's not nothing. It's fine. Nothing amazing, but it's fine. Try and get away. That's good, like staying near the minions when a crow's bouncing around, but not going close enough to where they jump to me. So that was good positioning there. Moo Moo, trying to come in. We don't know where Fiddle is. Ping out, he might be here. With these plants thrown down. This is good. This is proper plant management to step forward. This is way out of position. Not going to be able to make use out of that one almost ever. Do have six now. So that gives me a lot more potential power. So stepping towards these two plants is actually good. I can root through them. And if I do, I can throw down my ultimate that will trigger the passive on the plants. Whereas if you ult on top of them, it greatly raises their attack speed. So it won't trigger this one. But these ones and any things that I had stored would be triggered. So this is good positioning. This is maybe a little bit too passive, stepping this far back. because it seeds this plant for free, as we see there. And again, I'm summoning this plant before I'm using my Q. Now I use the Q. Now, because when you place a plant from your ability, they get a certain amount of invulnerability time, this plant does still spawn, but I lost the other two plants for free. If those plants triggered, this fiddle's chunked below half health, I would say, easily. Unfortunately, fiddle makes good use of the plants there, bouncing it off of that to vein. Walking through the ward, so I'm pretty sure that was warded at least. I think we had seen it. Yeah, I think we saw that ward go down. Or we had a strong inference because Fiddle was missing and was around there. Mumu tries to make the most of it. He hooks. He throws it around. He does a wrap around the minion wave because the minions aggro towards him. So they actually give him an opportunity to straight line it right past him. Great play by Mumu. He's able to throw down the ultimate, which will give me enough time to follow up with my roots so Fiddle can't leave. Shen ult comes in immediately. Incredible map awareness by the Shen. Wow, well played. This does root the Fiddle. Now it's an opportunity to burst Fiddle before Shen can arrive. Heal comes out. Not gonna happen, perhaps. Fiddle flashes away. No, I throw out my ultimate. Don't hesitate. Now's the time to kill Fiddle quickly. We have some number of plants here that are going to get buffed by this ultimate. Throw the plants out. And remember, it's with my ultimate. It's not when the ultimate triggers the knockup when it does the damage. It's right now. As from the center point, vines come out towards the edge of the circle you see indicated. They come out in all directions simultaneously. And it's when the plants come out that it does damage. So the plants haven't damaged Fiddle yet, but he is still within the range of the circle. So this plant root, this vine root right here, can do damage and kill him. That ends up being what's happening. Unfortunately, Shen's ult triggers immediately before he dies. So it does complete. The good thinking with this, Mumu's tears are just constantly playing in my ear, it's ridiculous. The good thing about throwing down this ultimate, Shen has no time to try and get out of it. So the knockup, he might not get damaged by it, but the knockup will happen. And Shen being here, the point in that is to for him to provide his CC and to engage all in. Because he's a tank, and he has a lot of ways to mess with us through his taunt. He could hit that with a taunt flash and get a couple of people. That's really strong. So getting the knockup on him delays it and gives us time to get out of here or time to turn on Lucian. He gets the taunt off first, but it does knock him up. Plant tries to aggro to him. I realize, okay, I'm full health. I need to be in the front tanking up some of this, even if I'm not a tank proper. I am the tankiest out of all of us right now, just by virtue of having full health. I'm at least equally tanky as Mumu is, depending on what he's built. And as we see, he hasn't built any resistances yet. He's built a little bit of armor, Ninja Tabi, which is actually pretty useful in this engagement. But I would argue we're about equally tanky just for that more health. Throw down the exhaust on Lucian. Good. Unfortunately, here's Udyr. Didn't have the ward coverage. He does flash, too. Unfortunate. Couldn't queue away in time. I flash out. Throw down that to root Shen to make sure Shen can't get me. It's arguable I should be peeling for a Mumu, but I think Shen might be able to get me. So, and since, again, look at our health right now, right? Now that we're equal in health, a Mumu's by far tankier. Not only does he have a little bit more health, but he's got some tanky stance, I know. Lucian flashes forward so many. I think everybody here has burn flash except Amumu. Amumu is the only one that hasn't burn flash yet. Good awareness to juke upward. Mumu finally does flash, joining the party. He tries to keep Udyr locked down. At this point, I'm thinking I'm pretty fragile, but there is no long ranged abilities anymore, right? This is the wrong way to be going from here. Once I saw this come out, I shouldn't still be going this way. this could have been instead, maybe even not that, but moving like this. And then as soon as I see that, I could be moving this way now. Right? I need to be respectful of the damage that can come out. And Lucian does still have heal, so this isn't a likely kill, though Amumu doesn't unfortunately know that. I need to give support to Amumu, right? And right now I'm not. I'm a non-factor. I've made myself a non-factor in this fight. So now I finally am starting to try to path towards them. I'm still doing it somewhat indirectly by coming like that. If I was already here and I was coming like that, okay, whatever. I'm setting up for a straight line skill shot for my route. But I could already be queuing right here. I could have gone a more aggressive route forward. And then I could E at a near point blank range and Q the entire line of them from here. Poor positioning on my part. Mumu's goes down for it. Luckily, the heal doesn't come out in time from Lucian. And Udyr does die from that shot from the turret. He actually probably, I think, should have survived one more. Though the turret would have locked on him and hit him pretty quickly, Lucian might have been able to heal him away in time. Almost didn't get that because I wasn't participating. I had poor positioning there. Not necessarily plant positioning, just poor physical positioning with myself. So, although I'm sure you could make an argument that Zyra herself counts as a plant. I'm waiting on an item here. I actually swap out the item at the last second because we got some additional turret gold from Tryndamere pushing, so I got a little bit better items before I left. Forgot to swap out the trinket. It happens. Especially when you're playing a more damage-oriented champion like Zyra. You might not think about the utility aspects of support as much because you're thinking about how to do damage. At least for me, I am. So I go forward. Position some forward wards. I realize that, so I use the trinket first in an expendable location. Try and save the sightstone wards for some deeper wards. Okay, make the best out of a poor situation, right? So I'm rotating here because I know the engagement's coming. I knew even before I moved the camera just now, I knew back before Zed died. So I'm rotating all the way up here because I know this engagement's going to fight. Going to be a long fight. But Yasuo's fed. So this doesn't even come close. It's gone. Donezo. And now this Yas is super scary, right? Now this is where I might have some future opportunities to be like, okay, I need to help this Yasuo. So let's see. We're thinking about moving in on this turret. Waiting for the minions. Plants will tank the turret. Prioritized over minions. So summoning plants can be good here. Don't really know where everybody is right now. We know one just died and respawned Zed. But we don't know where anyone else is. So I'm saving everything just to be safe. Okay, it looks like we get this turret. Shen shows, Lucian shows. No real threat. No need to worry about it. Try and back away in time to give Lucian most of the local gold. Alright, blue buff. Nice to have on Amumu. But Amumu's gonna be getting our blue buffs because they do literally nothing on Yasuo. So, I take this one. Great. Yasuo goes in, right? We're worried about this blue buff and then retreating. But Yasuo's going in, and he actually goes into what I think is coming out of the fog of war, a fiddle by him eating like that. We need to immediately be going back to support him. Maybe this is just a mistake that could happen, but how we react right here, there's a little hesitation. If we were there to support him, this would have been a little bit cleaner. Well, it would have been possibly a double kill, so whatever. It's fine. Not as big of a deal. Little things add up, though, so. Summon the plant. It's a little out of range of the turret, but it does delay those plants. Those two plants give me plenty of time to stay forward and then walk away. So I got an extra like one or two autos in on the turret. Alright, let me get it. Where are we going now? We're walking mid because I don't really need to back yet. We're setting up for dragon. Okay, he has speed, so just throw down a ward to keep an eye out for him. Position myself back towards here to complement Vayne. Try and get the root. Poor plant management there in that I didn't, or just a missed opportunity rather there. I think plant management is going to be a theme for the show this time, you guys. Hopefully Zyra players will find this helpful. But that's just a poor reaction time for me to not get that root. Okay, whatever. This plant is protecting the seed, so you won't see me walk towards the seed. And the seed is less important at this point than just bursting this out. So I want to, even if it's just my auto attacks, want to be throwing this out. We get it. Good. Try and get rid of the blast gun so nothing funny happens. Maybe it's arguable I shouldn't have, so we could use it because we have arguably control over this area, but whatever. He gets a blind shot on Lucian. Lucian immediately dies. Great. My root hits Fiddlesticks. Great. Great, great, great. Grouping around the fed Lucian, or excuse me, the fed Yasuo there. This is where I want to be. This is what I said earlier, right? Now, maybe walking through here was a little bit suboptimal of a path, walking this way, right? Maybe I could have followed them, gone that way. I think it's arguable, and I was going back towards this minion wave to try and push it up so when they come out here and kill these minions, I can evaporate these ones so our minion wave actually reaches them. We can maybe establish a line of scrimmage, I guess, right here and free us to rotate up top. But they find Zed. Fortunately, I wasn't there in time to help. I think it's as big a deal. Udyr comes out. I turn around fairly quickly there. Do get the root onto Udyr. Got the plants out. He kills the plant. The only one that actually did summon. I get damage on him. Can't quite make the knockout. Flash. Bandage toss from Mumu actually finds him. Puts him in a lot of danger. We're right here. We try and kill him first. I'm slow on the exhaust there. That's a little slow on the exhaust. I wanted to save it for Zed, but I think this goes back to one of our previous lessons of I need to be willing to use abilities more quickly, especially since he flashed defensively. He's coming into play here, sure, and it looks like we're about to all three be fighting to the death, or all five be fighting to the death, because he's stepping forward, so I'm trying to get to him. But if before, I could have done it even before the smite came out, before that auto came out. I could have exhausted Udyr. I'm being a little greedy trying to wait and exhaust the Zed to get it off on him. So, see previous lesson of... I'm actually not sure which lesson it was, but see a major point in one of our previous lessons of being a bit more willing to use the summoner spells. Unfortunate. He does get to E there. I think this was a really good route by me. As soon as that happens, as soon as the Shen comes out of nowhere and taunts Yasuo, it's my job to make sure he can get away as safely as possible. Start positioning this way. See the Fiddle's going to ult. Going to just try and get them. Not worried about these two as much. Worried about the Fiddle that's about to be right here and Shen. So I position a little bit forward. Make sure my E can come out this way. Since Fiddle, I assume, is channeling just to be as close. He's not trying to ult like this to keep him on the outer edge and space themselves out. And you can always tell from Fiddle's body, he's clearly directed... that line wasn't drawn very straight, but he's directing himself that way. Just from the position of his body, you can tell while he's channeling. So he's going to appear right here. So I position myself here to hit the root on both of those targets. Ends up being a little bit better. Throw the root down. I think I actually... I'm not sure if that was one of my stored plants or it was a passive. But I wind up actually hitting Lucian too and almost got Zed. So that was a really good root. That was good positional awareness. see our previous episode on positional awareness with Braum, which, you know, you might think Braum positional awareness. We did a long episode on positional awareness with Braum. It matters quite a bit. Zed comes in. Good of myself to confidently walk forward, because, like, what's he going to do other than this? Great. A little bit slow. Good use of the plant there. I believe I threw... Let's watch that again, just to make sure I threw out the plant. Second to throwing out the actual E. It's hard to tell. Should have started the vines sooner. But I think it's a little bit mismanagement on the plant. And it procs the Thunder Lords, which gets the kill on him. So I actually wind up with a kill there. Even though that worked out, again, I think that was a little bit mismanagement. I should be throwing out the E first, noticeably first, and then summoning the plant as the E animation is about to reach them and trigger. So a little bit mismanagement there, but nothing too severe. Window shopping for quite a long time. I think I'm waiting on an item here. Yeah, I don't know exactly what I was waiting on. Maybe it was his Antone, but doesn't really matter so much. I ran as quickly as I could here, so I don't think there's any opportunity there to involve myself. Oh, he died so hard there he quit the game. He DC'd out. So I'm supporting Yasuo right now. Again, he's clearly, he's the man. He's the man to support. And I've been, this is a question we asked at the start of this replay before we got in. Could I have been around Yasuo more this game? I don't think so. I mean, obviously, yeah, I could just walk on top of his character model the whole time. But I think this is reasonably as much as I could be paired with him as I can. It gives Vayne plenty of time to be alone and farm herself up, make herself a threat, which she has been farming quite a bit to catch on up and definitely surpass all of her counterparts on the enemy team. But also I'm enabling Yasuo to keep popping off and doing his crazy Yasuo thing. Good micro away from plant there. Beautiful flash taunt from Shen. Not sure this is necessarily the best fight for them, especially because he sets himself up for a root from me that will hit both of them. But hey, you know Yasuo needs to be shut down. You're Shen. Sometimes you take this. There is no follow-up from his team. They aren't even going to respawn in base yet. So that's why I'm a little wary of this. But whatever. It's fine. Summon that plant here to get a zone of control. Where's my draw? Gives me a zone of control from this plant. Because the plant actually, that's an E plant. The zone of control is more like this. A little bit like this. So Fiddle's right on the edge of it. Shen is actually just outside of it, I think. Fiddle on the edge of it, getting a little bit of damage coming from this. It's going to be mitigated by his heal, but it's going to be keeping a little bit of persistent damage coming as soon as he stops channeling his heal. That's fine. I line myself up to get a very clean shot so I can root both of them. All right, that's fine. Perfect example why it's important to get the plant there. He's a squishier target. It's important to root Shen so he can't do anything about this while it's happening. Vines come out, do a little bit more damage. You guys can see the flurry the plant goes into. Plant starts to do real damage. Yasuo cleans it up as if Shen wasn't even a tank, thanks to some of that additional ambient damage coming on me. I think that was good plant management there. We're just pressuring this down. Shenmue is splitting. He's low, so he doesn't need to come join us, put himself at risk. But this is less about getting this turret and more about just freeing up Tryndamere to continue to split. Plant's being summoned for my passive. I think this was a missed opportunity here. Instead of going like this. I mean, I don't want to be stunned by Udyr in his turret range, especially because I'm not putting a high priority on actually getting this. But if I had gone a little bit back like this, I had a straight Q shot right there, and Udyr has no way to dodge out of that. Maybe this plant only gets one shot off because both of these aggro to it, or at least one of these turrets does, and it dies immediately from a single turret shot, so it's not like super tanky or anything. But it does get a little bit, maybe one, most two, but probably just one attack off. But it hits Udyr and will proc my Thunderlords on him, which is some amount of damage that matters, because again, maybe it chunks him out enough to where he backs off, and we actually can keep pressuring this, completely freeze up Trin to get this, and then start to work on this one. And then maybe we even get this one and can fall back here, right? So I think this is a little mismanagement of the plants. By the time I do, this one expires just from time. Plan changes a little bit. I think just get the root. Okay. Enough damage. Yasuo is so tanky. It's so early in the game. Udyr doesn't even have his armor items yet because he's trying to build Triforce after getting his Blood Razor enchantment. He's squishy enough to where he dies. Crazy. So we have crazy control over their base right now. I come help just do a little bit of wave clear so Tryndamere can focus on the turret. Don't want to leave Yasuo too much. Especially because Yasuo is trying to... He's become that Yasuo player everyone thinks of when they think of playing against an enemy Yasuo. So he's like Flash trying to knock people up. He gets it on Lucian. Unfortunately, he doesn't get it on Fiddle. But I come back as quickly as I can. Not bad. Throws out the wind wall there. I'm not sure if that was to block the drain. I'm not sure if that actually works. But regardless, he's leaving. The drain is done. He gets a double kill. Barely survives there, possibly from dangerous game alone. That's fine. I throw down exhaust. Shen can do real damage, but not when exhausted. Even to me, the squishy caster support, I'm fine. Summon a plant. Let's zone him away. Try and establish control here. Now Yasuo's like, whoa, I shouldn't have been able to do that. I'm out of here. I don't care how fit I am. That was too close. Understandable, understandable, especially since we're not significantly healthy. But we're enough to where we can get this, so even if Yasuo is going to back, we can still get this. Additionally, with Amumu coming in, it's even safer. Amumu coming in amplifies my damage a little bit, so that helps us together melt through Shen. Amumu, I'm focusing on getting this, these two things. Amumu's focusing on getting the kill. He can do it. He's built some damage. He actually didn't build damage. There was another Amumu we played with today, actually, who went damage, so I'm thinking of the wrong game. But he does go in on this Shen. He does clean him up, I'm pretty sure. He has enough damage. We can clear this up. Yasuo, after backing and filling his health bar right on up, teleports in. And that's just GG. It's over. There's not much that can be done. Help focus down this turret. Second turret falls shortly thereafter. Base is done. I've got so many plants. Spawn just passively. I throw down these two just to give us a zone of protection over here. Doesn't even matter. This game's over. So, what was the lesson to come out of all this? Unfortunately, it's not one that's going to be widely applicable to all of my champions. This is, I think, a Zyra-specific lesson. But it is a very important lesson. And there are some things that this will lend itself towards with other champions. Because, I mean, it's not, we're not playing StarCraft here. It's not all about unit management and micro or macroing the position of your forces overall. But this is that kind of aspect that it raises itself in League, right? How do you move Tibbers? How do you move Warwick's giant ghost lady, whatever her name is? I'm sorry, I don't play Yorick. I don't know what her name is. How do you manage when and where you spawn the Voidlings from Malzahar? Pet micro is important and matters a lot. And that's essentially what we're talking about here with Zyra. The plant management. Since Yasuo was doing so well, And I mean, at one point he was like 5-3-2, I think, or like 5-3-something. So he wasn't as monstrous, but recognizing that he was the snowballing guy, I stuck to him. That was good. Stuck to him, helped him snowball further. And once I did, I was back in my groove. And I think some of the problems we saw early game are not things that I necessarily need to drill over, just because this is the first game I've had on Zyra in a while. So I think a little bit of rust shows itself. But this is where that rust was. And the important thing about letting yourself... Some people will be like, oh, I don't want to play a champion in ranked, because even though I'm warmed up for today, I am not warmed up on that champion. It's been a while since I played them. Let yourself do that. And notice where your rust is, right? A little bit of rust mechanically can be overcome if you're already warmed up and you're playing optimally macro and you're trying to rotate properly. But then do it perfect, as we saw in this game. But I think I did all right with that. And once I came into my groove, the rust, I had a lot better plant management by the end of the game, and the rust was sort of working itself off. So don't let yourself be discouraged from that. But when you do that, notice, especially at the start of the game, what the rust was on, because that means that's the weakest area for you on that champion. And you're going to want to have an additional amount of mental focus on that mechanic. For me, it was plant management with Zyra. When to spawn plants, when to not spawn plants, when to give up seeds, when to fight for seeds. Those were the things I was struggling with in lane. And that's why Vayne didn't snowball out of control either. Now, she was set up to snowball if, for whatever reason, it didn't wind up working out like this with Yasuo, because she was getting so much time alone that she was catching up very quickly in farm. And she was positive by the end of the game. So she was set up to go off and be our late game answer if we needed one. Luckily, we didn't need one by any stretch of the imagination. But that was okay. She would have been much further ahead, and she would have been, or I think I would argue that she would have been snowballing herself by the end of this, even though it ended very quickly. I think she would have been had a snowballing scoreline, like a 5-2, 6-2, something like that. Maybe a 6-3, because she was getting more involved in the action, who knows. But I think she would have been hitting her stride way earlier than that late game hyper carry stride. She could have been snowballing at the end of this game if during laning phase I had had better plant management. So the fact that Yasuo did carry this, great. It shouldn't have been all on his shoulders though. Putting all that weight on his shoulders is risky. Now he was able to deliver, great. Thank you, Yasuo. Tip of the hat to your carry. But we should have been able to enable Vayne to do better and shoulder some of that burden as well. We didn't, because during laning phase, I wasn't enabling her as much as I could have with the plant micro. If I had been managing my plants better, I think we could have had a much stronger laning phase overall. But that's okay. Again, we're not stressing about it. We won that game. We had a good day today again. We came out... let me show you the profile really quick. We started at 1 LP. We ended at 87 LP. Pretty good. Pretty good. I'll take it. I'm happy with that. Not perfect, but an important lesson, you know? And again, this can be extrapolated to everybody. If somebody's very positionally oriented, like an Orianna or something, when you take them out and you know you're going to be rusty at them, try and anticipate that a little bit more. I should have done that here with the plant management for Zyra. Obviously, that's going to be Zyra's most intensive mechanic. I should have had a little additional thought towards that and given it a little additional priority. Didn't, and it cost us a little bit. Didn't wind up costing us so much that it cost us the game. And I think some of my other strengths showed through with trying to focus on positioning myself towards a snowballing character, enabling them to snowball even more. Since I'm already a very strong early game champion, I think that was the right call. I think I had good game sense to do that. I think I positioned myself properly on the map. I made proper rotations. And that's why we finished before 20 minutes, you know. It's part of the reason why. But again, we could have done better. this is an important lesson. And if you're a Zyra main, or you know a Zyra main, send this video their way. Especially if you think they could use better plant management. don't use these lessons to flame people. But, you know, I think this is an applicable lesson to anybody who plays Zyra. Anybody who plays a champion with pets, or some sort of positional micro like Shen's sword, can take lessons out of this. But, yeah, we're going to call that the lesson for the day. We had a good day today. Thank you all for tuning in. Thank you for those of you on YouTube who tuned in for the lesson. I hope this was helpful for you. Feel free to share this video around. Again, especially if you know Zyra main, share this video with them. Hopefully they can improve. Looks like we're on the climb again. We're hitting our stride. Hopefully next episode we're going to be hitting those promos and we'll continue to climb up. We started this year at this season at Bronze 1. We're already in Gold 5. Let's see how high we can go, shall we? Thank you all for tuning in. I'll see you next episode.